brought somewhere.
Okay, I'd like to call this meeting to order, please. Welcome everybody to the Karegnondi Water Authority meeting. Again, things I'd like to stand up and address the office by Dr. Weaver.
What is the nation's flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Standing for the office of the office.
Heavenly Father, we pray for your wisdom, your guidance, making decisions for our community, partnerships with the board, bringing clean, abundant flow of water to our communities. We pray for those that have endured this man-made disaster with the water situation in Flint, Michigan, and bless those men and women who serve this country.
Amen.
I just have a little bit of a roll call, please.
Eric Mays.
Present.
Larry Green.
Here.
Richard Hamel.
Here.
Michael Lynch.
Here.
Vicki Hoffman.
Here.
Dr. Laura Sullivan. Sheldon Neely is excused. Thomas Verchek. Marsh Benelli. Paula Zelenko.
Here.
Dr. Karen Weaver.
Here.
Gail Curbison has been excused. Joseph Suma.
Here.
Jamie Curtis.
Here.
And Greg Alexander.
Here.
Also present is the Chief Executive Officer Jeff Wright and Corporation Counsel Kevin Kilby.
Thank you. We do have a form of. On the agenda, number one, the minutes from both the government and the corporate board meetings and the authority board. The motion by Curtis, support by Suma, to accept the minutes as presented. Any discussion? Eric?
Yeah, these minutes would reflect where when we were dealing with the, these would be the minutes from the chairperson. No, correct. And so these meetings, these minutes would reflect where the motion was made, where at some point, if I look at them, I can recall there was an issue, and that's why I abstained from that one vote, because there was a dispute as to what had been said and did on the record as we move forward with the chair. So I'll make a discussion item. I won't change the minutes. I won't say anything further. But, you know, if you recall, and if no other commissioner gets into detail on it, then I'll leave it at that. But clearly, there was a dispute as far as a motion on the floor, what was said and done, and then it moved forward. So, you know, the majority will do what it do just as they did then. But I wanted to, in discussion of acceptance of the amendment, highlight that, the reason for the abstention. And I might abstain again, but I'll wait to see what other commissioners say.
I will amend my motion to reflect.
Any further discussion? All in favor of the motion, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. Motion passed. Treasurer's report.
Trudy Nichols, treasurer of San Antonio as well. In your packet, there was reports that look like this. Are there any questions for the treasurer on these reports today? Sir?
If I may, Mr. Chairman. This, by me being new, and you can kind of help me, Mr. Chairman and Commissioners, I always like to hit the ground running. And so when you look at this particular report, I would think at each meeting we get a report of this nature prior, correct?
Correct.
And I don't know if there'll be another chance to discuss finance and the treasurer's report, but at this time, would there be any discussion about where we at on budget and if we on track based upon, is that further along the right?
I believe that's incorporated in the discussion on where we stand.
Okay, so verbally, where do we stand?
As far as budget, that won't be my part of my presentation. That'll be further on in the discussion. Correct. Will that be Mr. Wright? Yeah, Mr. Wright will address that for you.
Okay. And I guess I'll reserve my inquiry or comment budgetary-wise for that portion, because we've had some discussion locally about some things that have come up that we got to do to connect with the Karegnondi. So, and understanding that and not being shy as I, you know, we'll keep moving, and I thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. If there are no others, we do have we just want to update the board of the audit. The Plant Moran folks are in the process of auditing the books for KWA. And at this point in time, we have indication that we will have a clean audit as we did last year. That audit should be completed in the next 2 to 3 weeks. Probably
sometime in March, but all is going well at this time. And that's all I have. Thank you very much, Judy.
Thank you.
I have Mike Curtis to accept the report, supported by Paula Zellenko. Oh, I'm making, I'm really pleased that we can thank you. Also, thank you, Dr. Sullivan, for showing up. Any further discussion about the treasurer's report? Hearing none, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. Motion passes. Now down to our CEO report.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And I'm really surprised that Dr. Sullivan was able to find the parking spot 30 minutes ago. I understand we have some new board members. Eric has some questions on the issues we'd like to talk about, and we have some other new board members. And because of all of the disinformation and other things that have been put out there, we thought it would be helpful to the new board members and to the people who watch this on public television to know, again, how KWA got going and why, and try to dispel some of the misinformation that has been put out there. So, there's been some different things said, and we've got a couple of them we're going to talk about real quickly. If there's any questions on them at the end, you're more than welcome. One of them is that somehow KWA was the one that forced Flint River. And the reality is, if we go to the next slide, it was voted on to go to KWA 7-1 by the Flint City Council. No time during those discussions did the river, was the river brought up as an option. That didn't come until later when the termination letter came from the Detroit Water and Sewer System. Also during that period of time, Genesee County did and is still on the Detroit system. The termination letter is also posted on our website.
Point of information, Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
Of, Mr. Wright, if you go back to the other slide, the point of information, or however you allow me to do it, a point of information is inquiring, you know, the one vote they keep thinking that's made. I wasn't even on the council at that time. And so, I wasn't on the council. I want to clear that.
I will confirm that, that Eric Mays was not on the council.
And even when you keep saying the seven yay votes, as it relates to the river, when you take a close look at that resolution, at that time, even though it was a vote to go to the KWA, that resolution was amended on the floor to blend river water if they fell short. So 16 million gallons, I think, was the contract, and it was if we went over to 18 or 20 million, you would blend river water. So in all fairness of the record, that 7-1 vote did have something to do with KWA and blending the river water. I pulled that resolution the other day, and so other than that, that's the only amendment or information that I was asked in that point of information form. Did the executive director realize something?
Well, the reality is there was no vote to go to the Flint River as an interim to KWA. There was discussion, if I may, okay. There was discussion from, I believe it was Sheldon, Neely, and others to Flint, if Flint didn't get enough out of the 16 million gallons. And that's the decision Flint could make any time. That's their decision to make. But there was no vote to go to the Flint River as an interim water source located in the river. That's what I'm saying.
I agree, because in that decision to use it interim, I was there, and it was no vote ever come before.
That's
right. So I concur, but I just wanted to add those things in as you discussed that particular 7-1 vote, and I keep hearing, you know. And so we ain't at that crossroads that we'll ever be.
So this is what actually led to the ultimate decision to temporarily go to the Flint River, and determination by the DWSD. They gave Flint 1 year, basically, to get off of their system. During that period of time, there may or may not have been negotiations between Detroit and Flint. I do not know, because we weren't part of that. But this is, in my opinion, what led to the use of the Flint River.
Point of information, is that letter in our packet? If not, could I get a copy of that?
It's also posted on the website.
Okay, I'm old too, but I would like a copy at some point. Sure. Thank you.
Why the need for KWA? Cost, reliability, quality of water, and voice of our own. These are the main reasons initially, and when you put those up against the fact in notorious documents, or at least an article, we can produce more documents, that the City of Detroit DWSD was in the process of building a second pipeline. The bottom line is there was going to be a pipeline built either by KWA and its partners or by the DWSD. The cost part of it has been worked out. There's many, many documents that show the financial savings to the people of Flint and Tennessee County particularly. The reliability comes because the state and the DWSD themselves realize that one single pipeline is close to 60 years old had to have a backup or a second pipeline built. Quality of water is the same. The Lake Huron water is what Detroit uses, Lake Huron water is what KWA uses. The voice of our own, you can see them sitting at these tables. On the DWSD, there were zero seats from anybody from Genesee County or from the City of Flint. Since the discussions in 2002, this is the rate increase documented from the City of Detroit. As you can see, when I became drain commissioner, we were paying about $8 a unit. Today, it's $31.78 a unit. Huge increases over that period of time. And really, that's what's driven the cost to be so favorable with JWA. The bottom line is, a minimum of $400 million will be saved by people of Flint and Genesee County on JWA versus JWA. There were discussions 2 years with DWS, and the discussions initially were to try to create a partnership with Detroit to build this pipeline. And then ultimately they walked away, and the result of that was their announcement that they were going to build a second pipeline for Flint and Genesee County out of Orion Township, and the cost would be $820 million. Considerably more than what we paid. They give the same reasons that I just gave, the fact that reliability was a concern for them also, because you have 2 million people on one single pipeline. And what really got everybody thinking about it is in 2003, there was a power outage that hit the Northeast United States, including Detroit. Flint and Genesee County was cut off from water for 3 days. Not to minimize what's happened to folks of Flint in the last year and a half. The only thing worse than toxic water is no water. And literally, Flint and Genesee County were without water for 3 days during that period of time. And that's when Detroit actually got real concerned about building a pipeline, actually went out and started design on it. We tried to partner with them. They ended up proposing it themselves. And again, the cost was almost 3 times as much. Again, no seat at the table, no votes on the board. All these documents would be available on our website, and I'll make hard copies for you to hear. One of the real misconceptions that's been brought up again recently, some 3 years ago, it was their last offer, supposedly, that Detroit had made to Flint and Genesee County through the state treasury. Refers to an $800 million savings was included in their last offer. And no one to this day can still figure out what that means, because the total cost for KWA for 30 years, including construction, financing, operation and maintenance, which means the labor, the chemicals, the electricity, etc. The total cost of KWA over 30 years is $736 million, less than the $800 million that we could supposedly save. So we haven't been able to figure that out, and it's not been explained to us in any way that is understandable. It also, that offer required Flint to use the Flint River as an emergency backup. It did not require a pipeline for them, but it did require the Genesee County to build a second pipeline, and that's all documented also. So we don't know where the $800 million came from. It didn't have merit 3 years ago, and now that we've actually bid and have exact prices for our project, it certainly doesn't have merit. This is one that has really been interesting to me. The KWA was conceived by myself and the Governor Snyder for fracking operations throughout the thumb. KWA cannot sell to fracking companies, cannot sell to any private company, cannot sell to any private individual. Only the communities that KWA services can serve individuals or companies. So KWA doesn't even have the legal ability, number one, to do it. And I think most interesting is KWA was actually vetted and approved by the Granholm administration long before Snyder took office. So the idea that somehow this was worked between the governor and anybody on this board is far-fetched, but it is out there. And I wanted to clarify the fact that this project was actually approved and vetted and signed off on by the Granholm administration. emails released recently by the KDIP, by the state, through the KDIP, is the right choice. DEQ, UWFT competitive options would require the city of Flint to meet a significant, if not majority, of its water demand by feeding water from Flint River. Rumors, they could have just stayed with the Flint Water and Sewer Department until the pipeline was in service. This is one of the big areas of public debate, again, out there in the papers, and the reality is, if Flint and Detroit had sit down, they potentially could have worked out a deal just as we did to stay on the UWSD system that they agreed. Well, one of the things that nobody seems to recognize, and go to the next one, when Flint went off the system, February 11th, 2015, Detroit raised the rates to its suburbs 11.3%. If you read the meat of the article, it says the sole purpose that Detroit had to raise those rates was to cover the revenue loss when Flint dropped out of the system. Then go back. And that generated some $15 to $20 million. And when I'm saying charging twice for right to provide water, that revenue is still being collected by Detroit. The revenue that was lost when Flint left the system is still being collected by Detroit. On top of that, you have Flint residents, the Mott Foundation, and the state of Michigan paying it again. So literally, Detroit is collecting revenue twice on the same water that the Flint folks are getting currently. To me, they should either reduce the rates back to the suburbs who they're collecting this money from, or they should give Flint the water for free because they're already collecting the money for it. There's been comments made by some, and some from Lansing even, that the support for KWA in Flint has been lagging. This is why I received this poll from, I don't know who the business person was in Flint, but they commissioned it with a practical political consultant. They sent it to us, it was done the 9th, 10th, and 11th of this month in Flint. And the simple question was, people planning to go with KWA or DWSD. And the results of the poll were 69.35% KWA, 30.65% to Detroit. So I don't have all the particulars of it. I know practical political consulting is a legitimate polling firm out of Lansing, but I don't know anything other than that. And it's encouraging that after all that's been said, the majority of people are planning are still looking forward to KWA. Mr. Chairman, okay. GCDC purchased a 9-mile stretch of unused pipeline from Flint for $3.9 million. Pipeline needed for reconnection with Detroit. Our people had a contract that would have required Flint to pay to use that pipeline. Because of Flint's needs, we wavered that contract and charged only $9 for 9 months for Flint to use their pipeline. We put our people out there, and we can go to the next one. We had our people out there for 5 days straight prepping that line. In fact, we had the line prepared before the city of Detroit was even ready to ship the water to Flint. So I give kudos to my folks, and we will do everything that we can to help the Flint folks from this point forward. Again, this is a partial list of the supporters of KWA, the businesses in Flint and Genesee County, the communities throughout, some of the elected officials, the farm bureaus, the agricultural people, the Flint Watershed Coalition, UAW Region 1C, Holloway Reservoir Homeowners Association, Sierra Club, as far as the environmental groups, etc. This list will be updated because there are many more that got added to this. I just had an update, but it will be updated soon. So the general reasons, again, DWSD versus KWA. DWSD, no seats on the board for Flint, KWA four. Control over the rates, DWSD none, KWA yes. KWA is a brand new system. The existing DWSD system is 50-year-old pipe that has to be replaced at some near future point. They both use Lake Huron water, and ownership for Flint in this particular case, no, the DWSD does with KWA. The DWSD offer, again, requires the Flint River to be used as the emergency backup with the current system. CWA has proven that the competitive bidding process that brings the highest quality, lowest cost water, and what it means to that is we have bid all the construction projects competitively to be up for KWA. That's one of the reasons we receive such great pricing in our contract. This was in today's free press, and it is ridiculous that Flint has, according to the free press, highest water rates in the country, the top 500 cities, and KWA will help bring that down considerably. And finally, I want to say something about the folks that live in Lafayette County, particularly. They have had to put up with a lot during the construction of this project, particularly the people that live along the route. I want to personally tell them that I appreciate all the inconvenience that they had to go through. The people of Flint, Genesee County don't necessarily realize that because most of the work has been done over here. I know there's been muddy roads, there's been stuck vehicles, and we certainly will make those roads better than they were when we came in. Unfortunately, it's not been the best type of year for this type of construction. We've had freeze, thaw, rain, snow, thaw, freeze, rain back and forth, and that's not made it the easiest to keep clean for everybody. I recommit to everybody in this community up here. I know that you've had issues with the roads particularly, and when this project is completed this spring, those roads will be in better shape than they were before we came through. Any questions or comments from the board? Yes.
I have a question. I'm sure going back to the first slide, where it says that KWA is not supposed to be from the water. What was going to be, when the council voted the 7-1 vote, what would have been that short-term solution if it wasn't
included? I'm assuming the assumption was by all at the time until you received the letter from Detroit terminating Flint, that Flint would stay on the DWSD system as we have until the DWSD completed.
And then, I
don't use that savings to start rebuilding the infrastructure. and then they also had a rate increase beyond that, if you remember correctly. So the savings will be there. It will be up to the communities to receive that savings on how they spend it or give it back to the people.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, through you, to Mayor Weaver, in line with the communications with Mr. Wright, and Mr. Wright, if I say something wrong, you or anybody can correct me for clarification. The termination letter from Detroit was dated a certain time, but even though they wanted to terminate, and they indicate terminating, once they seen the KWA vote move forward, they didn't actually terminate. They left the door open for the city of Flint to continue to negotiate, and the emergency managers refused to go to the table and negotiate, and the city of Flint then, through emergency manager early, pushed the button. And so while there in fact is a termination letter there, the actual act to cut the Detroit water off and refuse to negotiate was done, in my opinion, by Mr. Early. And so in my opinion, we might could have negotiated and continued with Detroit water, whether we got a lower price, a high price, or whatever. So I want to put that termination letter in context. The actual termination did not happen until the day that the button was pushed. I was on the council and I was standing there, and that had to do with the implementation of the use of the river water from Mr. Early. Also, the selling of the pipe. If you look at the 9-mile pipe that was sold, you would see a vote of so many yea and so many nay. That also had discussion of leasing that 9-mile pipe, because we didn't know, some of us, whether or not we would have to use it again. But that sale of the pipe to the county that we now have to use, and I appreciate Mr. Wright allowing us to use it, was so, in some people's opinion, prematurely. That decision was made by emergency managers to sell that pipe prematurely. Whether the council voted to sell it or not, in my opinion, it was going to be sold, and it was going to be sold for $3.9 million. And so some council persons, for whatever reason, rubber stamped that sale at that time. I did not, for whatever reasons, and it was discussion about leasing. It was discussion also about how monies and what prices, but that vote would reflect as well. And so emergency manager's decision played a role in all of this, and I think that must be clearly understood, because some of these decisions that I just described was not as clear cut by the elected officials as it relates to termination from Detroit. As a matter of fact, Mr. Chairman, I would end by saying this. Once we seen that there was some major problems with the quality of the river water as it relates to lack of corrosion control and others, the council, on a motion I made, in fact voted to return to Detroit Water and Sewer. As a matter of fact, in about January of 2015, I had Sue McCormick come to the council, and she wasn't even given the courtesy to communicate. They treated her like Councilman Mays and only gave her 3 minutes. So those are the facts. Oh yeah, those are the facts as I know them. And so they ignored our cry early to return. And so the rest is kind of history. And so we did end up negotiating during a political contest, in my opinion, to return to Detroit Water and Sewer. And if I may, this is not fact, this is editorializing. If there was a race 3 years down the road, I believe the decision might have been made to attempt to put corrosion control in river water and see what would happen. That's just my little caveat, but we all know where we're at now. And so I had to throw those factual things in for Mayor Weaver, if this conversation takes place in a public arena, and Mr. Rice, if I was wrong, correct me, but I think that is very accurate communications that I just gave on the record.
Chairman, I wouldn't disagree with anything Eric raised and said. The decision to go to Flint River was made by whoever was operating Flint in the state. Our office, DWA, had nothing to do with the decision-making process. Where you're even more to the point, and I think people really need to understand this, the decision to go to the Flint River is not what created the problem in Flint. The decision not to use corrosion control created the problem. You could have went to the river, you could have used corrosion control, and we probably would not be talking about it. So to me, as an outsider looking in, corrosion control decision was the biggest factor that led to the problem.
I was
going to
say, I was on top of it. The decision not to use corrosion control is still kind of on the side of the law.
On that point, this is something that's kind of bothered me, and maybe you can clarify it. My understanding is that the decision not to use the corrosion control was made by the company that made the design changes to our treatment plant, LAN, which is the same company that is contracted to do some of the design work for the KWA. And it just concerns me that this entity that made such a big mistake for Flint is an entity that you're working, that we're working with the KWA. And I'm wondering, I don't know, if that's occurred to you as well. And is that
well, there were 13 different engineering firms that were working with KWA.
Okay.
One of the things that we wanted to do was make sure as much money stayed in Flint as possible. Land was located in Flint, Row is located in Flint. I think land has since moved to a new office outside of Flint. Wade Trim, Craft Engineering, all of the local firms were given a portion of this project for design. As far as what land did at your treatment plant, we have no idea. It's not one of our contracts. In fact, it's one of the bullet points I could have put up because somehow there's this where they clipped some videos together and left a lot of the editor's story come to talk to me. He asked why I gave land the contract to do the Flint River treatment plant. I have nothing to do with that. KWA has nothing. Now that being said, land has done a fine job for us. All of the engineering firms that are working on this project satisfactory and great as far as I'm concerned. I don't know if LAN was the decision-making process in that, if it was staff, if it was the DEQ, and I think that's why the investigation of all the involved is the most important thing, because the lack of corrosion control is 95% of the problem at Flint, because of that is what Flint is facing. So we weren't part of those discussions. I don't know what those contracts entail. And as far as the work that all the engineers, including LAN, are doing for us, it's been quite satisfying.
Yeah, and if I may, I don't know if I would look at the lack of corrosion control as, I don't know if I'd go high as 95% because you had problems with TTHM, which could be a lack of corrosion control. I know, I want to make it clear. Jeff Wright and I talk regularly. I've had
for a long time.
Yeah, I've had to learn as much about water and infrastructure as Forrest Gump had to learn about shrimp. So that's one of the persons who I talk to regularly. So when you hear me talk in this public arena, qualified, we had problems with TTHM. We had some other bacteria problems. Mr. Wright there might have flushed out systems differently than Flint folks flushed out systems. So, you know, I don't know if the lack of corrosion control still might not have messed with, you know, problems like Legionella that we're just hearing about, because all of these things, you know, the lead, I understand the lack of corrosion control. I understand the rest of them, because the lack of corrosion control eats up the biofilm and you got all kind of stuff floating and moving. So I'm just going to hesitate on the 95, but we had other problems. The land and road engineering report, and yeah, we do have engineers. We had two engineers on board, land and road, Dr. Sullivan, in 2011, when the documentation and the analysis that says we ever go to Flint River water, this is the chemical content and the small amount of money that was listed for phosphate, which is one form of, you know, corrosion control, was right in the report done by land and road, submitted to the city, the mayor, it was addressed to. So we don't know why land and road didn't jump in earlier, but we do know that it was there. And we do know that city of Flint officials knew it was there, didn't choose to add it into the chemical cocktail. We do know that the DEQ regulations and rules that they should put under EPA guidelines intensely didn't order it to be there. And so we know it's enough blame to go around. We know there's investigations, thanks to some of Mayor Weaver's talking, the first line of investigation that we didn't have under emergency manager law was the right for our legislative body, the city council, to swear people in, get questions under oath, and you can look to see that happening. Try it to happen tomorrow, the next day. I done talked with some certain colleagues to get to the bottom of stuff for months. So as we move forward, we do want to continue to say to, just like Miguel did at the EPA, we don't throw the EPA out, you know, the baby with the bathwater. We don't throw land out because they had certain people on site who didn't step up to the plate. See, if you step up to the plate in these dynamic arenas of our water plant, in the dynamic arenas of the EPA, you can get arrested. You can be told to be quiet. So we know we're not throwing the EPA out, baby with the bathwater. We ain't throwing land and row out. But it was some individuals connected with those entities and agencies. And just like me, some people probably say, I wish you would shut up now. But when we have a position, in some cases, you have to step up to the plate, whether anybody listened to you or not, for the record. So I would just say that based upon what I know as investigations go on. And if we get our democracy back, we'll be showing you what happened and forward in some of those sworn testimony and documents along with other investigations. And I thank you, Mr. Chairman, for letting me chime in. Wasn't that quick?
Is there anything more for the CEO report?
I just have one last comment, and it's really going back to what Dr. Sullivan and Councilman Graves were talking about. We're not throwing everybody out, but we are going to keep what's going on, because we want to keep the people accountable all this time. And I guess, I think what I heard in Dr. Sullivan, and correct me if I'm wrong, is bringing up land, because one of the things we have to do for Flint is to rebuild trust, and so many people here in Flint, red flag show up for us, because even though they said these things needed to be in place, it was still, no one spoke up about it. So it's an issue of trust for us, and that's what we've been trying to work on. So I believe that's why it was questioned.
End of report?
Yes.
Very good. Next on the
If I may, we held one training session, and it was well attended. We're going to hold another one for the board members that want to come. We have some of the good board members who want to come. You're all welcome. We'll try to get dates set in the near future. And it basically just talks about bylaws and corporations, data, procedures that KWA uses for open schools, et cetera. So we'll be scheduling another one.
Very good. next on the agenda is Corporation Council Report.
Thank you. Follow-up to what Mayor Weaver and Councilmember May said, KWA is now in the process of fulfilling several FOIA requests and subpoena requests we received in connection with water at Mission Park. We've been in the process of fulfilling those requests. We'll continue to do so as they come in and cooperate with any and all agencies that have inquiries as the KWA's involved.
Your report?
Your report, sir.
Okay. Down to old business, we have none. New business, we have none. Number six on the agenda is a public comment period.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
I did want to raise something up under new business.
Okay.
Under new business, since I've become a member of the KWA, as I sit on the council, and as Mayor Weaver has included me more so in city business than others, we'll see if she likes it or regret it, but she's done it. The point is this. I've sit in on a meeting with her legal department, the city of Flint, and our staff as it relates to what I'm going to call new information and new requirements about the city of Flint connecting with the KWA. What I mean by that is, based upon some of the debacle, in my opinion, of the quality of water, we now have to test that KWA water coming in for 3 months out here. Right now, whether it's going to be shorter or longer, to make sure that we're treating that water correctly this time before we start to try to sell it to the city. And as we sit around the table, and Mayor Weaver, just jump in because, you know, you correct me if I say anything wrong. As we sit around the table, and some people here might know, we had to come up with a way to continue to feed water from Detroit into Flint and to the customers, and while at the same time receive water from the KWA connection and treat it and, you know, get that right for 3 months. And so when they described to me that the water from Detroit was kind of just passed through underneath and the tanks that we have in Flint would be testing and receiving water, then I say, okay, I see how maybe some of this can go on for 3 months. I'm going to still see how it's got to be dispersed once it comes in the tanks and we keep getting river water. I mean, Detroit, Lake Huron water. But my point is this. That price tag I hear then went from $3 million to $9 million. And I said, if the city of Flint shouldn't have to struggle with them costs for the $3 million, because we bonded and we part of the KWA, and they kept saying the KWA budget was on schedule and under budget. So
it still is.
And so I hope we can stay under budget, but I must raise the cost now that we have to do, because the connection from Port Huron to Flint ends with Councilman Mays or Commissioner Mays at the point of the water plant. And so I don't want the city of Flint to have to board this without raising the issue with the KWA and say, we might be looking for another $3 to $9 million to finish that connection to kind of help us connect if we find it in pain. But I would say this as I close and then I listen. Beg your pardon?
The state.
I was going to end by saying that. You took away my thunder.
That's right to do.
I'm making a record to show you how well informed I was. I was going to end by saying, as we watch the money come in from the state because of the great work that's been done in declaring a state of emergency, and now the governor is moving and, you know, being receptive, we might not have to go there, but I wanted you to stay on guard so that we can make sure, and for the record, that would be brought up, because that became new business to me since I left the last meeting.
I mean, Mr. Chair, Eric is always hard to follow, because he is a Michigan.
Michigan State, you better watch your mouth. No, I bleed green.
If it weren't for the lack of corrosion control and the problems that that created, then this second pipeline that we're talking about would not be necessary, period. So in my opinion, the decision to do that and those who were involved with it should be the responsible parties for any additional cost that the city or KWA might incur to make this connection. Because without that, this second connection would not have been necessary.
I want to make sure I remember things correctly. If it weren't for all this that had happened, was the Flint River to be the backup for Flint?
Always has been the plan from the city of Flint.
So at one point or another, we would have encountered this problem.
Well, the Flint River has always been the backup for Flint. They have fired up that plant every year for several dozen years as an emergency backup. I think, Doctor, the problem becomes is when you use it as an emergency backup for 2 or 3 or 4 days, compared to a year and a half, or whatever it is to be. I don't believe, though, that the river, based on what I've heard from the mayor's office, from EPA and DEQ, will be, at least in the short term, never be allowed for even an emergency backup, even though it has been that for dozens of years. That was a plan, though, as far as Flint was concerned, but there are other options that time that these pipes that Eric had brought up would also bring into play.
Right.
And I think you're aware of some of
that.
I think moving forward, we should all just realize that for the foreseeable future, Flint River is not going to be used for any drinking water purposes. And again, the decisions or the lack of decisions to do certain treatments to that water should be the factors to who should pay for these extra costs that are going to be incurred because of that.
And then I have another question for new business. There it seems like there has been discussion back and forth about when Flint would begin to receive KWA, whether it be before the county complete builds its treatment plant and receiving KWA solely, or whether it would be after the treatment plant is constructed. And my question actually rises from the training session that we were at. And recognizing the reservoirs that you have in place for a power outage and the reservoir that would be in place with a pumping station at the new treatment plant, if Flint were to receive some of the KWA water before the county treatment plant is built and that pumping station is ready, I was concerned about a power outage and the ability to supply KWA water to all the way to Flint when that pumping station that's in the middle has yet been constructed.
Well, there's actually several points you make and a couple of questions. The pumping station that is being built in the pool is for the sole purpose of ultimately being used to supply pumping for all water.
Okay.
But there's a redundancy in the system.
Okay.
The existing pumping stations that we have in Brown City and at the lake can also push water all the way through without utilizing that one pumping station.
Even with that high pressure head?
Right. It's more cost efficient to use the one that we're constructing solely for plant. But it can be done from the others also. I think that's going to be one of the decisions that ultimately has to be made is what do you use for emergency backup? The Flint River is one source. It's really only two options at that point. You can try to have a contract with PWSD or KWA for finished water, because we also have the capability of not only putting untreated water, KWA lake water, to the Flint plant. There's also the interconnect where we can actually, for a short term, in an emergency, take treated water from our facility and actually put it into your system also. So there's multiple options there, as you well know. Those all are being discussed by Flint folks, DEQ folks, us, who talked to us about it. I don't know where that's all going to end up. We tried for almost 2 years to negotiate a emergency backup with the city of Detroit to avoid building that reservoir. The reservoir cost around $15 million was to build that reservoir. And we felt that we could reason with Detroit that in an emergency, we would utilize Detroit water instead of going to the reservoir itself. And in writing, the best we could get from the city of Detroit was $11 million a year for 30 years, whether we use the water or not. And when you compare that to a $15 million reservoir, one-time shot, it was really no brainer to go with the reservoir, which could also be used by the city.
Well, I guess I'm really right now just thinking about before that reservoir is constructed and before the new treatment.
Dave, you did make a good point. One of the things that has been brought up by the point person for Governor Snyder at a press conference a week or so ago was that additional monies needed to be allocated from the state to buy Detroit water in November of this year, not July as originally mentioned.
Okay.
And it was Mr. Collins who said that he didn't believe, based on who he'd been talking to, that the city would be ready for the KWA water, even though KWA water will be available in June or July of this year, on time, on budget. And he didn't think that the city's facilities would be ready at that point in time, so he was going to ask additional dollars from the state to continue to buy EWSD dollars until the Flint was ready. He estimated it would be November.
But your facility won't be done then, will
our, it? Our facility is not, our scheduled facility, our water treatment
right.
facility, not the KWA.
Sure.
Our water treatment facility, our best estimate has been June, July of 2017.
Right, and so my
there
only...
could be a six-month right.
And so I guess my question is, should there be a time when Flint is looking at receiving KWA money, KWA water, and your facility and reservoir aren't constructed yet?
The reservoir will be ready. The ability to push lake water to Flint will be this year. The reservoir is 90% complete right now. It's a treatment plant that will
right.
be ready.
But my concern is the in the event of a power outage that takes down the pumping station here in the pier, I'm guessing. When you were looking at your contingency plan for in case there was a power outage for you, that was the reason that you had that reservoir constructed, right? And then
what? Well, that is what we have done also since is we have two power peaks, two BTE peaks. Not just one. So the whole DTE system has to be before we lose power that facility. Because there's two different plants feeding that site.
So you say at the facility, you mean at the new plant?
Our
new. Right, but I'm thinking again about your contingency plan for should there be a power outage at the pumping station. That was the reason for your reservoir, as I understood.
I've got to ask my, doesn't that pumping station have a backup generator or doesn't?
Yeah, again.
I can't. There are some that have backup generators, yeah. Some of them that have dual supply. So
yeah, the lake station has dual supply. The intermediate station does not. Our treatment plant has dual supply. The intermediate station does not.
Okay. But from the reservoir, you've got a dual supply.
Correct.
Energy source.
Correct. But. So the question was is since the Flint River is not a viable backup supply, during the interim, when only Flint is taking KWA water, and that's, they can still get DWSD water through the county. And again, it really depends on what the city backup, the bunker backup supply is, whether it's going to be the county backup as a backup or the fresh backup. And those can be arranged so that they can work their own.
About 6 months. Did you hear that, Doctor?
I think I did. So you're saying that, I mean, what I was hoping to hear was that Flint didn't need to worry about a power outage along the KWA before the new treatment facility was constructed and the new pump and the pumping stations and reservoir were ready. But it sounds to me like you're saying is that should there be a power outage at the intermediate pumping station before you're up and running, so we can't pull finished KWA water yet, then our only other options would be county water, continuing to take water through from Detroit through the county. Will it still be available to us once you're constructing?
Well, and again, it relies on, the city has to make a decision since they've taken Flint River off the table to back up water supply.
Sure.
They have to identify what their new backup water supply is.
Right.
Once they identify that, then that pipeline or infrastructure can be constructed, which will also supply during that interim period.
I guess what my point was I was hoping that we wouldn't need a backup if there was a power outage at the intermediate pumping station, but it sounds like we would need one.
If you need a redundant supply.
I'm going to take new business off the table. I realize we went back and forth and talked about all the water. I'm going to go to the comment. We'll be able to comment.
Mr. Chairman, if I may ask for your indulgence real quick. This is a KWA meeting. Glenn is here, and we are his partner. And so we must discuss backup, whether it's KWA or Detroit, and we must do it in a timely manner, where we can construct the infrastructure to handle that. So if you don't want to stay on this in new business, could I politely ask that it be put on the next agenda or old or new business? And so really, believe me, that's a vital discussion before we move forward with spending money in KWA. We must discuss from the city of Flint. I don't know about you, but the city of Flint got to discuss KWA, Detroit, backup, two backups, pipes, infrastructure, and we got to get that in place. And we got some cost if we use infrastructure, as Mr. O'Brien just said. So I'll be polite. And I won't prolong it, but this is a meeting. Construction is moving. I'd rather be proactive, safe than sorry. But guess what? Next meeting, old business or new business, it should not say none, because I'm asking that this be put on the agenda, because we need to discuss that infrastructure and these options of KWA in Detroit as backup and what we will do.
Yes. We're glad to put it on the agenda, Eric, but it's a decision that has to be made by Flint and the state. If I may finish, KWA has no part in the decision-making process of what Flint will use for the project. Once Flint has decided what they want to use, then we can work on the cost. And I think there's people in this room that are already starting those discussions, and on this board that are starting those discussions. And until that's decided, KWA has no say on what Flint uses for its emergency backup. Would it be available to Flint? Absolutely. But it's not KWA's decision, it's Flint's decision.
Mr. Wright, in all due respect, I am a representative of Flint, and the mayor is here, and I know as we go through our discussion and decision processes, I understand what comes first, the chicken or the egg, but I'm going to also look at what KWA cost and what their assistance can be when I look at KWA versus Detroit, the pipe we sold to y'all, building infrastructure while construction is going on. So I am a city official. I do understand making decisions for the city of Flint, but I also understand timing and construction, and I'm gonna stay the same. I would like for it on the agenda, because as we make decisions, some of what we hear from KWA as far as construction and knowledge and infrastructure, to me, it's going to have something to do with the decisions we make in the city of Flint.
I already told you, you're more than welcome to put it on the agenda, and it will be.
That's my request, and I'm...
For the record, it's not a KWA decision on what Flint uses for its emergency.
We understand, but let's go a little further. Let's say City of Flint use KWA as their backup. Then we will be at a point where we must discuss what we're doing. So I understand. I mean, remember, I'm Michigan State. I'm asking that it be put on the agenda. And I'm saying that we understand all of that, but we understand good information and gathering information and getting information proactively as we, you know, we wouldn't want to construct the KWA, make a decision to use it as a backup, and then have to go back and do some more construction. We want to be ahead of the curve in making decisions, and I can't speak for people before I got here, mayors before I got here, but the mayor got me here, and I'm saying since I'm here, I want to know what the KWA construction deadlines is, because if we pass the pot, the infrastructure hooking in, it could be more expensive to go back and dig up and put pipes rather than right now have a pipe that can branch off two ways. I mean, I got my idea, but I'm being respectful to the chair, and so I know what I'm saying. And we ain't gonna do it now. The chair wanna go to public comment. I acquiesce, but my point is made, and I hear what you're saying.
It will be on the agenda for next month. I hope you don't leave it at this discussion to wait for a month. I hope you give a report on what discussion you have going forward.
Oh, and I do, Mr. O'Brien, but I have to do it in a public arena as well as behind the scenes because I'm an open meetings type of guy.
Okay. As we go to public comment, I just want to reiterate what Sheldon Neely asked last month. Everybody be conscious about any misdirected responsibility that you directed at KWA. We do understand we've had several discussions even today back and forth about the Detroit, Flint, Lot River, and the KWA. This is a KWA decision. If you have this experience with what's going on in Flint or the state of Michigan, I appreciate you taking it to Flint or the state of Michigan. This is a public comment. This is not a debate. One that wishes to go up and speak. I have to state your first name for the record. You can state a question and it will be answered through the board comment when we have that.
And it's the nicest damn job that you'll ever see. And if this board continues to do this kind of work all the way through, they're going to have every penny spent wisely. And I want to thank Mr. Eric Mays, who I first met tonight, for here for picking my mind and telling all these people what I meant to tell them, and I don't have to now because you said it already. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, sir.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Tony Baldino from the city of Flint. I like the way you separated Flint from KWA right from the hit. I don't know if you can feel what we feel, and I'm not trying to make this a Flint issue, because you guys all look pretty healthy to me out here. I'm scared. You guys are talking about this and that as far as who's going to help this and who's going to help that. Me personally, I think you two, AWA and Detroit, should fight for our love. You guys are sitting up here acting like this is a joke. I'm here and laughing here. This isn't funny. This is life-threatening to us. Understand something. I've been in front of you, Jeff, before. This is no joke. This is going to cost the city of Flint ungodly money. And here's where I'm at. You used to pay Flint for Detroit's water. We're supposed to be partners. I don't feel partnership when we get 35% of what you're getting. Understand that. If we're going to be partners, I'm looking at 50-50. I also feel that we need to bring Detroit into this conversation. We need to find out more of what's going on for the simple fact that if you guys become a monopoly in this, we will have no say. My other question is this, and I'll sit down. When it comes to this building, I'm understanding if we miss a bill, we're going to get bumped around. I'm afraid you're going to jack us up worse than Detroit. What kind of protection will we have? If you say it's going to be 35%, and it ends up being we're down to 20%, what kind of money will we get back as a city? Remember now, you used to buy our water from us through Detroit. I don't think this is a 50-50 situation up here, all the way to Port Huron. And I'm worried about us not being able to take care of any in case of an electrical storm. Why don't we have some kind of situation where we can store our own water? We as Flint, Mayor, we need to look at us. I'm tired of playing this game with everybody around us. And I say, and I am, as a concerned, sick and tired resident. Thank you. We need to look at this.
Any other public comment?
Yep.
Thank you. My bad, I'm going to get over here so I don't have to put my back. My name is Jim Casha, living in Norwich, Ontario, Canada. And in 1979, I was working in Flint on a tunnel project. We were doing lots of infrastructure upgrades and water main replacements and sewer upgrades. And my boss, Fred, was the guy that built the Port Huron water intake tunnel 6 miles out into Lake Huron to give Flint the cleanest drinking water on the planet. So I know a little bit about water intake tunnels. I built some. Fred taught me two very valuable lessons. Actually, we taught me a lot more, but the two most important ones, the secret to pollution is dilution, which is why you're drawing water out of Lake Huron and not the Flint River. And when you make a mistake, the first thing you need to do is admit it as soon as it's made, and then we can get fix the problem at the lowest possible cost and the least cost damage. Fred was one of the smartest men, if not the smartest man I ever met. He's weeping. Great. And the 22 men who lost their lives to give you that clean water are also needed. Anyway, before I came over here, I stopped at the Flint, the Masonic Temple, and I rented it for March the 6th. I'm going to hold an open public discussion, and you're all invited. Anybody's welcome, any of the public, to attend from 11 o'clock till 5 o'clock. We'll be discussing all the issues related to DWSD, Karegnondi, Great Lakes Water Authority, and whatever, and Flint. And this morning on the Michael Patrick Shields Show, I've been up in Lansing, Dr. Weaver, you'll appreciate this. I've been up in Lansing trying to get help for Michigan's foster children affected with brain damage with prenatal alcohol exposure. I left my engineering job in 2006, come up from Washington, D.C., thinking that would be 5 minutes. It's been 9 years, and I ain't got it done yet, and you just took my money. Help lead damaged children, and the state now has put these brain damaged children from alcohol on the back burner. This is wrong. We cannot wait for the people in Lansing or DC to solve our problems. We have to do it. So it just happens that March the 6th is the debate. And I heard Governor Snyder say on the Michael Patrick Shields Show this morning that the EPA is not stepping up to the plate and bearing their share of the responsibility. And here's the note I held up for him. Normally he reads them, but he didn't read this one online. It says, the federal EPA has been telling Michigan they have a problem with the regional water system supplying Flint since Snyder was 18 years old. He's 58. This is a 40-year drought. And I want to know why the federal government and the state government has not stepped up to the plate and solved this problem long before you had to do forced into a situation of Karegnondi. Now, I don't think this is the best engineering solution. I think there's better options, and you need a two pipeline, so you got two pipelines, but maybe there's a better solution, and if we discuss this intelligently without politicians, we'll come up with the right answer, all right? So, I hope you all can make it there. You're all most cordially invited.
Everybody but you, Eric.
I will get it done. I just did it at the last minute. You got it, bud? You tell everybody.
Okay, my question is Jeff Wright. Because when you know that we were in a problem that we were in, why didn't you stop KWA and come help us? Because we needed you. That's why we mad at you. You don't understand it. You keep coming up with all of these other things. It's because you didn't stop this to come help us. But we tired of that. But we tired of you going around trying to shove us around telling people, oh, you can't talk about this and that. We were poisoned and we're sick of this. And we coming right for you for answers and you trying to put us to the side. But we not going to be by it no more.
you had to start answering a question. Why didn't you help us? Or why didn't you stop KWA when we were Jim Poison? Now, where are you at?
This is a public comment.
So he just commented.
That's okay. You should have answered it. If I was him, I would have been a man and half.
I will answer. Not now.
Yes, you can.
Next, another comment, Jeff?
Yeah, my name is Shane Hodges, and I'm from the city of Flint. And one of the unique positions we are in now is Detroit's willing to negotiate with us. So if the city of Flint could negotiate, say, 50 years again at lower prices than what you quoted earlier, what could we do with what we own in KWA? Could we sell it to other people? We're not allowed to sell to fracking. Did I hear that earlier? What kind of things could we do with that if we were to decide to just stick with Detroit, make sure we have a clean, safe source, and do enterprise with our KWA, what we own in that situation?
Your questions are noted, will be answered in the final comment.
All right.
Any additional public comment? Second call. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm. My name is V.O. Luster, and I'm out of Palm Beach, Florida, originally from Flint. And then my question is on the integrity of the pipeline itself. I'm just concerned of the material and the lining, and does that have any effect on the? Well, does the raw water under pressure, under velocity? What is the deterioration rate of the inner liner of the pipe, and what's the projected replacement cost and timeline for the pipeline?
Thank you, Vito. Final call for public comment before we go to board comment. I'm going to start with CEO Wright so you can answer the majority of the questions.
Well, some were comments, some were questions. Larry, thanks for your comments. Tony, thanks for your comments. Jim, you got a meeting coming up. Sounds like he's going to talk about a lot of different things there. Mr. Jackson, I don't understand why they think that we can chase and you or downtrod the city of Flint. We've done nothing to try to help. The KWA itself is the best long-term solution for the city of Flint and Genesee County. And this kind of goes into the question that Shane had back here about Detroit. If you sign a 50-year, 30-year, 20-year contract with Detroit, there still has to be a second pipeline built, as the article showed you earlier. KWA didn't come out of thin air just to say we need to build a pipeline. It was in competition to what Detroit said had to be built. The difference being is we're doing it for a third of the price of what Detroit would have done. So if Flint wants to try to negotiate with Detroit, number one, I advise you to get it in writing. And two, realize that there still has to be a second pipeline. Period. That's the way the statutes and the laws are, and Detroit has stated it themselves. I don't know what KWA, back to Mr. Jackson, could do more than they've done. I personally, at the county or the council meetings back when Flint decided to go with KWA and was talking about going to Twin River, I personally spoke up, and it's a matter of record, and suggested and recommended they did. All you have to do, Mr. Jackson, is go review the tapes. So, bottom line is KWA is the highest quality, lowest cost water for our region. And whether KWA were built or not, a second pipeline would be built. And Buster?
Yes, sir.
The design criteria for this particular pipe is 100 years, actually. It's got a mortar lining. It's got concrete, or I should say concrete, it's mortar. It's got steel, it's got corrosion control, and the design expected lifetime of this pipeline is 100 years. As far as pushing untreated water through it, I know that Dr. Sullivan had asked, in fact, we have copies of the multiple communities throughout this region that will supply to anybody that wants one. The multiple communities that push untreated raw water through similar pipelines, not only in the state of Michigan, but throughout the Great Lakes region and the Northeast.
Thank you very much. Larry Green, any comment?
I just hope that the board members and the residents remember this is a solution working to help make all the regions from Port Huron through Genesee County independent and able to control their own destiny, and it will be cheaper over the 30-year contract with Detroit.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Sullivan?
No comment.
Hamill?
No comment.
Any comment?
Councilman May, or Commissioner May, yeah.
Yes, okay.
I would make these comments, you know, to the public. We got a $7 million so bond payment that we might have to pay over the next 20-some years as it relates to decisions to join the KWA and do before some of us even became familiar with. I can remember a time when the council voted 7-1, whether there was an emergency manager there or not. I wrote the language along with Bill Alexander. I wrote it to circulate a petition to get so many votes to put it to the ballot of the people. And, you know, it was a way that the people could chime in. But timing is everything, because we couldn't get to 8,000 signatures in a short period of time. And Jeff, you remember that. And at that point, people could have chimed in. So timing is everything. That's why, Mr. Chairman, and the KWA board, we're in a timing period right now where, yes, by statute, you have to have a backup system. KWA got bylaws. I keep hearing about the county treatment plant, Genesee County, but Flint is inside of Genesee County, so it makes sense that if the county got a treatment plant, statutory backup, Flint independent operating with its treatment plant, I do want to have dialogue with the authorities and decision makers of the KWA for the Genesee County and all of the county of the sense that it makes to Walling was the chair. Josh Freeman them was in my spot. And I don't know if had I been here on the inception of the board, would I had have said, we want some joint ownership in the treatment plant. I don't know if I had have been here at the inception of the board, would I had have tried to get stuff as it relates to backup, whether it was backup for Lapeer, Santa Lac, Flint, or whoever. So just, I just want to make a comment, Mr. Chair, by saying, one of the worst things we can do is governing bodies, and I hear you loud and clear. You say, hopefully, before we get to the agenda item that I requested, I've done my homework, whether I talk to board members or Mr. Wright. I've been talking to Mr. Wright for years, so I do that. I talk to the mayor and Ms. Sullivan or whatever. But y'all can feel free to call me, too, public or commissioners, so it go both ways, 810-922-4860. That's my cell, 810-922-4860, because we have a tendency to like to get in and out of these meetings and have meetings away from the public eye. But my position is, if it's important, I meet from 10 o'clock in the morning to 10 at night. Sometimes don't care if I break for lunch, but guess what? We have to meet, and we only are a body when we do meet. So I thank you, and I look forward to trying to do what's best for all of the partners involved. God bless you, and amen.
What's the number?
Yeah, what's the number?
810-922-4860.
Oh.
I just want to welcome the new members and explain mind that it's an honor to belong to this board. I've been here from the inception. It's good to see the progress that they're making, but I think we always have to remember that we're all in this together, and we have to back one another, and we have to support one another. So I appreciate the dialogue that we're having. If one community is having a struggle and another community isn't, we all need to be there to hear that. We all need to be there to help them help through it. So, and I appreciate this board because everybody on this board, anytime I've had an issue, they've been there for me. So I want to thank you all and welcome you to the members.
Thank you much. Mike?
No, it's just Mike.
Mickey?
I just wanted to say that I like having a voice that we don't have in regard to Detroit City. And it's very important. We saw that combination on one of the slides, the advantages of having KWA work in Flint working together. You're absolutely right. But in fact, I put out a press release today, so I hope you get a chance to look at it, because the state and the feds are each pointing the finger at each other and waiting for one to step up, and neither one of them have. And in the meantime, we're the ones that are suffering. And while they're pointing the finger, we're still consuming, or maybe I should say not consuming, we're still living off of bottled water, and we're still getting alerts that we can't use the water. Just yesterday, they found some. So, you know, we're in a bad spot. So I was glad to hear you say that, because that was my anger, and that was what I put out there today, is we're tired of them pointing the finger and nobody stepping up for us. So I think you're going to see something happen that we're pushing.
I believe you with the mayor's words and the past our needs.
I've heard a lot of discussions of the mayor leadership, I directed their water movement.
a setback, wait for the state to refute the finding of the fact. We declared emergency, do not get separate. And everything happened that way. Where we have to. And we're tired of the band-aid problem. We're tired from real action. And it's always been, and I've said in meetings with you, it's been a top-down approach. Appropriations of money have been top-down approach. Meaning, they say, here's a pot of money, and this is how we're going to allocate. And it doesn't fit with the need. And I credit the mayor for that. In the town hall meeting, when Rachel Maddow was here, if you remember, there was one nurse for all of Flint Public Schools. And there was an allocation of money coming to Flint. And there was no money for that. Just that one town hall meeting, they reappropriated that money out of the House Bill 5220. The Senate did. And it's 5 months. No. So we are working. And I'm committed to not letting the state divide the city and the county. Because they'll try to start a war, hopefully. Throw some money at it. Go back to Lansing. But you know what? This is a partnership that will always be everlasting. And I'm committed to working with the city of Flint. I have a good rapport with the mayor. And we work well together. She has my unconditional guarantee and commitment that I will continue to communicate with you. And I always have. And I have always said to you. And I have these conversations without a reaction. I am on the Flint Interagency Water Board. This is governor. His board, and he added more people to it. Dr. Sullivan is on there with him. They're not going to divide us, and they're not going to push us around. And we keep fighting the fight, and we're going to get the city of Flint clean, affordable water, and we're pushing to get the pipes replaced, and the money allocated. And I want you to know the National League of Counties, the County of Tennessee, no longer belongs to. Because we couldn't afford it during the recession. But Tim McGuire from MAC, Michigan Association of Counties, is going to D.C. And we have put together a comprehensive plan from our Genesee County Health Department to get things that are needed for all of the residents of the city of Flint and franchise customers. And I have a conference call at 4:30 this afternoon with them. And we are going down there, and the White House has reached out to the National League of Cities, to Genesee County. So we're working through DC Network to help Flint to get on the right side of this. And there'll be a backup, and I don't want to wait a month. And I agree that it needs to be on the governor, and we need to have a discussion. Mayor, we need to sit down and figure it out fast, sooner than later, and we need to have people responsible.
Thank you, Vice Chair Commissioner Curtis. I have no further comment. At this time, I declare this meeting adjourned.
He adjourned. Right. So did you just come to visit or?
No. That's why I got to go.